Okay, so today we have Blockbuster by the Sweet, or just Sweet. And I've done a reaction, I think just one, to this band before. And of course, I know of Ballroom Blitz, I know of Little Willie, I know some of their songs, but I don't think I know Blockbuster, which again is one of their big tunes. And that may sound weird to say. But here we go today, finally coming back to Sweet. So let's get into this, talk about it after, and let's go. Oh my.
Watch out if you got long black hair. You come from behind, you go out of your mind. You better not go, you never know what you'll find. You look in his eyes, don't be surprised. If you don't know what's going on behind his disguise, nobody knows where Buster goes. You steal your woman out from under your nose.
Hey.
Does anyone know the way? Did we hear someone say?
We just haven't got a clue what to do.
Does anyone know the way? There's got to be a way.
To Blockbuster!
The cops are out. They're running about. Don't know if they'll ever be able to Blockbuster out. He's gotta be caught. He's gotta be taught. 'Cause he is more evil than anyone here ever thought. Does anyone know the way? Did we hear someone say?
We just haven't got a...
Does anyone know the way? There's got to be a way.
To Blockbuster!
Someone say,
we just haven't got a clue what to do.
Does anyone know the way? There's got to be a way.
To Blockbuster!
Now I know what the siren's all about. So, Blockbuster by Sweet. again, when I listened to this band, I have to say Brian Connolly on vocals here. I feel like he doesn't get the recognition he deserves. And again, I know I haven't listened to a ton of Sweet songs, but I feel like I know enough to just say Brian Connolly's voice is one of the most, I mean, enigmatic voices I've ever heard. One of the most energetic voices. Just his little, when he would say during the song, they haven't got a clue or whatever. And he would come in kind of more closer to the mic or whatever. And his voice just, I don't know, he had such an incredible vocal ability. I mean, my God, that's just about as plain as I can put it. And again, it's a shame how he passed away. I believe he had trouble with alcoholism and all this stuff. But again, just what a vocalist. Good Lord. that's just how I had to say that off the top. But I love the harmonies here too, between, he and Steve and Mick and Andy. I just love the, just beautiful. I mean, my God. And, as well, I just love, again, like I said, how the siren starts off almost reminds me of Inspector Gadget, intro or whatever. But, just that waning, sound is just like, again, it kind of hurts the ear. And again, we're talking about Buster here. Again, Blockbuster. I thought it might just be the whole word Blockbuster, but again, Buster is a person, and he's not apparently a nice person. I almost get vibes of Jim Croce's you know, badly word Brown or whatever, just that kind of a thing. Or, you know, Jim, you know, you don't mess around with Jim, you don't mess around with Buster here, it sounds like. And again, you know, especially if you have long black hair. And and again, he doesn't sound like the best character, and that apparently they can't catch him. And you know, again, there's a lot of urgency here, there's a lot of fear, I would say, too. And and again, I just love the fast-pacedness. Is that a word? The fast-paced style to this, too. Because, again, we're talking about a guy that's on the run. You know, somebody that needs to be caught here. And, yeah, and I just love Billy's kind of whole... Or Billy. Brian's whole thing. I was thinking of Billy Connolly. Brian Connolly here. Brian Connolly's whole kind of, I guess, approach to this song, to kind of do it in this way, to kind of sound fast-paced and kind of sound fearful. Because, I mean, that's what the lyrics kind of want you to do here. Because, again... Buster's on the loose here. It's not good. So anyway, I just really enjoyed that. Like I said, I can't say enough good things about Brian here. Great kind of drums I have to say on this track too. Very prominent. Very good bass work as well. You know, very, and I say it a lot, but again, I thought it was bold, bombastic. Again, I thought the song here was very, I mean, you could hear the drums, for God's sake, because it was a very rhythmic, thunderous kind of sound, to go along with Brian's, you know, high vocals and just what he could do at this point. Because again, 1972, I do believe, 73, this came out January 1973. I mean, Sweet were just on the top of their game at this point. This lineup, in particular, like I said earlier, Steve Priest, Andy, I gotta look at their names now. I remember Steve Priest, I know Brian Connolly, Mick Tucker, and Andy Scott. These four were, you know, Sweet. And at this point, you know, you had hits like this one, Little Willie, and then you would have, of course, you know, Ballroom Blitz would come along, Fox on the Run. I mean, it's just, I mean, these guys had so many good hits. And yeah, anyway, I feel like they're kind of overlooked sometimes as, you know, one of the best bands from the 70s, really, when you get down to it. But anyway, you know, I'm just going off now, I guess. But with the lyrics here, you start off, you better be aware, beware, you better take care, you better watch out if you got long black hair. Again, just kind of a random way to start it off. You know, if you got long black hair, you better watch out. And at this point, you know, back in the 70s, I imagine a lot of people had long black hair. I mean, the people in Sweet had long hair, but I don't think they were all had long black hair. Anyway, he'll come from behind, you'll go out of your mind, you better not go, you better know what you'll find. You never know what you'll find. Again, talking about you might run into a Buster here, it sounds like. You look at his eyes, don't be surprised if you don't know what's going on behind his disguise. So again, it sounds like Buster can dress up in a disguise. You know, again, you can't trust this guy. You don't know where he is. You don't know what he looks like, because again, he might be in a disguise, for goodness sakes. And then just the whole kind of point of not knowing anything about this guy. Nobody knows where Buster goes. He'll steal your woman out from under your nose. Again, Mr. Steal Your Girl here. Does anyone know the way? Did we hear someone say? And then again, like I was saying, when Brian delivered this line, we just haven't got a clue what to do. It just, I don't know, the fearfulness, the whole theatrical kind of style that's going on in this voice, I really appreciate it. Does anyone know the way? There's got to be a way to Blockbuster. The cops are out, they're running about. Again, just nobody, they're running around like with their, you know, a chicken with their head cut off. It's just like looking for this guy. But again, we don't know where he is. We don't know what he could look like. He's a slimy, sly mother frigger here. Don't know if they'll be able to Blockbuster out. He's got to be caught. He's got to be taught. Again, I love that. He's got to be caught and he's got to be taught. You know, I guess maybe be taught a lesson here. Because he's more evil than anyone ever thought. Again, he's evil as hell. It's not good. I mean, my goodness gracious. And then we go on. Does anyone know the way? Did we hear someone say, we just haven't got a clue what to do? Again, everyone, you can just picture the scene. Everyone running around, just kind of yelling, screaming, whatever the hell, sirens are going, Buster's out there somewhere. It's almost like, you know, reminiscent of like a Halloween movie or whatever. It's like Michael Myers is on the loose, or it's like Leatherface is on the loose, whatever the hell. You know, just, it's a monster out there. We don't know what to do. We're trying to find him, but goddamn, he's sly as hell, and he's just, he can go wherever he wants to go, and we don't know where that is. And this is the kind of stuff I find interesting. So here on songfacts.com, it talks about, in December, David Bowie's The Gene Genie peaked at number 2 in the UK charts. The following month, this song went to number 1. And I do believe this is their only UK number 1 hit, which is nuts. I mean, Ballroom Blitz should have went there for sure. Anyway, both songs use the same Yardbirds riff from Bo Diddley's I'm a Man. Guitarist Andy Scott recalled that the band had a very panicked reaction, and a man from the record label asked, you know, why, and he said, and we said, that's the same fucking guitar riff as Blockbuster. He said, well, it's quite similar, isn't it? And then Andy said, it's the fucking same. He said, I got on the blower to Nicky Chinn. Of course, Nicky Chinn and Mike Chapman wrote the song. Anyway, got on the blower to Nicky Chinn, and he said, we can't release this. Nicky said, don't worry. There are completely different kinds of records, and I predict this one will be number one. I thought, good luck with that. But he was proved right. A few weeks later, we were at number one, and Bowie was at number two. So again, I just like to hear kind of the story behind the scenes or whatever the hell, and just that whole kind of, I guess, coincidence that they both kind of took the riff from the Yardbirds, who took the riff, I guess, from Bo Diddley's I'm a Man. So yeah, just a fun little story there, and just interesting to me anyway. So there you go. Again, just an energetic song, fast-paced. Brian Connolly really, you know, shows off his chops here. Love the harmonies, love the kind of bombastic feel the song had to it as well. And the looks of these guys, too. I can already imagine, you know, their hair, the suits they wore on stage. You know, I just love the sight of them. And again, they're a great band that I feel like they don't get the recognition they deserve today. And anyway, so yeah, I guess that's all I'm going to say. So thanks for watching. Thanks for liking, subscribing, commenting, all that stuff. Appreciate all the support, and I will talk to you fine folks again soon.